Ooh, this is so exciting. I never seen a voice lock in action before.
Let's hope Jasper's pharmaceutical special blend hasn't affected his voice enough to keep it from opening the door.
This facility is currently experiencing a heightened security event. Accessing this facility requires voice-modulated passphrase. Please speak the passphrase.
We attest to the zest with our hand on our chest. Be impressed as our guest by what we've finessed. You are blessed to ingest what we thoroughly test. You've tried the best, now try the rest. Spacer's choice.
Passphrase accepted. Access granted. Welcome, Dr. Jasper Lowe.
To believe something so awful as Adrena time came from a place that looks so normal. Normal aside from the bodies, I mean. And the blood. Oh, so much blood.
Thank you.
Hold on. I thought this place was supposed to be abandoned. You think that could have been the spooky voice from OCI? The one calling themselves the ghost?
Quite enough of you!
Thank you.
Roscoe, it's Georgie. If you're hearing this, you must still be holed up at the Sprat Shack. And you're not gonna like this one bit. I was trying to steal our recordings when things went crazy. I know. Like I said, sorry. And I'm gonna be in a heap of trouble if I don't get them, so if you wanna save my bacon, you need to do it for me. I need the 3 interviews we did with Ambrose, this one here, plus another recording of my own. I left that last one with a guy who owed me a favor at the garbage processing office in the chemical waste ravine. I'll leave an automech near Stellar Freighting. It'll want all 5 recordings, plus a passphrase. Glacial Age. Oh, and don't listen to my log, all right? Just stay safe and keep your head down.
I'll keep quiet. Not very sanitary anymore, if it ever was.
Devil, do I use this thing? Is it what? Oh, the barrel's turning. All right. I feel like an absolute idiot barking into this horn. I shouldn't have let Lucien talk me into this. What use do I have with audible notes? Posterity, my ass. Ah, great fucking law. What's it doing now? Jasper, it's... How do I turn it off? It won't.
Just press the button.
The what?
Oh, for law's sake, the button, Ollie.
Accursed thing.
You got that?
Now. Okay.
The effects of Compound X are inescapable. The refined excrement of the xenocyte life form. It's a fine powder, very fine. It finds its way into absolutely everything. Even in the water now, and the air. It settles like a veil over all of Gorgon. The laboratory techs get the worst of it. We all appreciated the boost to mood and productivity at first, but we're at each other's throats in an instant now. I've had to break up 2 fistfights this week alone. This aggression must be inherent to the formula, to Compound X. How do I stop it?
Careful. Seems like they had a surplus of traps they decided to get rid of all in one place.
God!
Mr. Lowe was awfully messy, wasn't he?
Searching for unauthorized persons.
the last of them.
Night falls on Gorgon, though I suppose it's always dark here in the void. The lab is empty, and I am at last alone. I'm preoccupied with thoughts of the single-celled xenocytes that make their home here on this rock. These primordial creatures persist despite the hostility of their surroundings. No.
How inconsiderate. especially after I've gone to so much effort to see Gorgon rest in peace. It's a good thing, then, that I finally figured out what you're after. I'll see you soon, little weasel.
Is it just me, or does it seem like our mysterious nemesis watches too many Aetherwave serials?
This is sick. I can't bear it any longer.
Night falls on Gorgon. Though I suppose it's always dark here in the void. The lab is empty, and I am at last alone. I'm preoccupied with thoughts of the single-celled xenocytes that make their home here on this rock. These primordial creatures persist despite the hostility of their surroundings. No, they require adversity to thrive. Perhaps that's why our bodies react to theirs. There is a harmony in us. The law didn't craft us for the void, yet we scrabble across its cold worlds, building, persisting, as the xenocytes do. We live. Against all odds, we live. But for how long?
since we've been traveling together, we've visited a lot of places that set my teeth on edge. This here makes my skin crawl.
I dare say it seems like the inmates were running the asylum here. The only thing they seem to be able to get right is sowing insanity and destroying people's lives. This whole project wrought mental destruction on everyone involved, including themselves. All brought to you by Spacer's Choice's Best and Brightest.
That might have been enough for me back in Edgewater, but after all we've seen of Halcyon? Captain, someone should have said no. I get now why Miss Ambrose would want to clear her mom's name. If the folks responsible for Edgewater's woes tried to blame him on my dad, I couldn't have let it stand. Hoped a smart fellow like Mr. Lowe would know better than to test a super drug on primals.
I'm looking forward to a breath of fresh air after the stench of this place.
Tell me about the production of Adrenatime, Dr. Ambrose. I hear Compound X is a unique challenge to work with.
It's temperamental. It must be refined under tightly controlled circumstances at tremendously low temperatures.
Do you compound it with anything else? Tell me more about your refining process.
Our audience is conversant in the sciences, very detail-oriented. So don't be afraid to get technical.
Last time I met you, you spoke like a groundbreaker Bildersprat. Why the sudden airs? And such specific questions? Does your minder know what you're up to? Does he suspect you're a spy?
Pardon me.
Thank you.
Hey, there you are. Been wondering how you were doing. Did you manage to find those recordings? Well, I'll be damned. Now I can finally get off this rock and go home. I know it's not much, but take the last of my bits. You've earned every single one, friend. She couldn't have been. We were together all the time. Except, oh shit, my weekly calls with headquarters. What could she even want to ask Olivia Ambrose about? Doesn't make sense. Good fucking law. Headquarters would kill me if they knew right after they killed her. Hell, being stuck here might have been the only thing keeping me alive. No, I mean, I don't know. Sometimes it seemed like there could be, when we were servicing the phonographs, or sharing a beer, but who'd be interested in some forgotten old bastard like me? Sure. Nice of you to say. Sorry. Not much in the mood for a witty repartee, what with the world-shattering revelations and all. Any other horrible truths you want to reveal to me? Or can I get back to my drinking? Listen, I appreciate you telling me what happened with those recordings, but I need some time to think. Got a lot to process. Yeah, I'll just... yeah. See you around.
Something busted, Captain? You want to ask about anything in particular, Captain? The stuff we saw in that chem lab really got my brain spinning, Captain. Folks there, they were like a family. Living and working together to change the colony. But the thing they made hurt people. Made marauders of them. Do you think they knew it would happen, Captain? Maybe. I think so. I guess I'm just wondering what's worse. If they hurt folks on accident, or if they did it on purpose. The result's the same, but knowing how they got there matters. Elsewise, how do we stop the corpse from doing it again?
Hey, Cap. I wish I could set this entire asteroid ablaze. No amount of booze is ever gonna chase the sight of a meat cube from my memory. I've seen animals tearing one another apart. I've shot folks, been shot by folks. I once saw Cat Malin shove an assassin into a sulfur pool. He dissolved. But those weren't choices. Manipillars don't give you moral options. What went on in those labs, the suffering they caused, they chose it. Yeah. You know, back when Monarch was abandoned, I sort of understood. I hated it, but I accepted it. There's a certain kind of consistency to the board's decision-making. It's about the bottom line. People are just resources with costs and yields. So, I used to think, well, if they're leaving Monarch, maybe they need the resources to build better elsewhere. Yeah, they spent the money on diet fucking toothpaste. Ain't no hope left in this colony, Captain. Not while the board's still intact. Good. I don't know what comes after that. I ain't exactly an expert on building a government. But if places like Gorgon are possible here, we can do better than that at least. Hey, thanks for talking. It helps.
Dust accumulation analysis. 2.5 years.
Yes, you caught me ruminating again. Guilty as charged. What's occupying your thoughts? Exploring the Human Inquiry and Auditing Facility was a deeply disturbing experience.
So then I says, fine, I'll pay you back for all of it. With interest.
Nice one. You must have had him quaking on their heels.
I mean, I wasn't really gonna do it. I just wanted to make him feel bad.
Pay you back with interest. I gotta remember that one.
Would have felt better if it had worked.
Good to see you, boss. Sure, I got time. I can't stop thinking about that human testing facility. Even saying that out loud makes me sick to my stomach. I keep imagining what it must have been like. Locked up cages, pumped full of drugs. After they died, Spacer's Choice just processed their bodies and tossed them out with the garbage. Boss, I've seen animals at a slaughterhouse treated with more dignity than those people. I always figured Spacer's Choice was no different from Anticleo or Brizzo or Hammersmith. They're all cogs in the same corporate machine grinding this colony down to dust. What we saw back there wasn't just corporate greed. It was pure evil. What's that supposed to mean? The colony's hopeless, so we shouldn't try and change anything? Look, never mind. I just need some time to sort all this out. Thanks for listening, boss.
Something on your mind? I've done some crazy jobs, but this one is more complicated than most. And I have a feeling we've got a few more surprises in store. Yeah, you know, I never gave him much thought before. They were just another occupational hazard. But the idea of someone creating them makes my stomach twist. Not something I'd like to dwell on. I used to think they were just more stories from the board to show how dangerous Halcyon was outside of a corporate township's walls. Marauders, dissidents, outlaws, they all just seem like different versions of the same boogeyman. But they all fall to bullets, so at the end of the day, the where and how didn't seem worth thinking on. You pointed out, and Spacer's Choice is just gonna point to their warning labels. Delusional violence is just another side effect. Besides, most people are used to getting a shitty deal from the corporations. Realizing that Spacer's Choice sold them a bad drug is more of the same. Gladly. Sure. Something on your mind?